You, Mark A. Baker, D.O., have been elected by the members of our association to the high office of president. With this office goes the responsibility for the success of the policies and objectives of the American Osteopathic Association during the coming year. You are charged with the task of providing leadership that will bring our association before organizations, elected officials, and the public. You are charged with the responsibility of naming able leadership who will diligently carry out the activities assigned to AOA committees. In addition, you are charged with successfully developing and promoting the programs that benefit the AOA family. I know that you will serve our association well and will accept these responsibilities to that end. I know you will also do the utmost to bring great credit to our profession during your year in office. Now, Mark, will you please raise your right hand and attest to the oath of office? Please repeat after me. I hereby swear or affirm that I, Mark A. Baker, D.O.,
I hereby swear or affirm that I, Mark A. Baker, D.O.,
will do all in my power,
will do all in my power,
to uphold the Constitution and bylaws,
to uphold the Constitution and bylaws,
of the American Osteopathic Association,
of the American Osteopathic Association,
that during the year,
that during the year,
I will carry out all of the duties of president,
I will carry out all of the duties of president,
to the best of my abilities,
to the best of my abilities,
and that I will deal justly, fairly, and impartially,
and that I will deal justly, fairly, and impartially,
in all matters which come before me,
in all matters that come before me.
This I solemnly pledge,
this I solemnly pledge.
Now it is my honor to present President Mark A. Baker with his president's ring. And
thank you.
And his gavel. Ladies and gentlemen, it's with great pleasure I introduce to you the 2017-2018 President of the American Osteopathic Association, Mark A. Baker, D.O.
Thank you, Lord. My pleasure, Mark. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Good afternoon. Let me start by thanking two of my lifelong friends, men that are like brothers to me, Dr. Jim Fralick for serving as the master of ceremonies, and Dr. Jim Chesky for providing the invocation. We grew up together in this great osteopathic profession. I would also like to thank the Texas Osteopathic Medical Association and the Texas delegation to this house. Your support throughout the years has made this all possible. Speaker Morrison and esteemed members of the AOA House of Delegates, thank you for the trust that you have placed in a very humble and honored man from Texas. The first action that I want to take as president of the AOA is to introduce all of you to the love of my life, my soulmate, and my sounding board, my lovely wife, Rita. Rita, would you please join me? Come on over here. Let me give you a kiss. Rita was the first member of the Baker household to become president of a national osteopathic organization, serving as president of the AAOA from 2000 to 2001. You've already met our children, Chris and Carrie. Chris holds a Bachelor's of Science in Mechanical Engineering and an MBA from Denver University, and he works at Lockheed Martin. Carrie graduated from VCOM, Virginia, and completed a pediatric residency in Tulsa at Oklahoma State University. She is now currently working with a pediatric urgent care group in Oklahoma City. Our children are grown now, but we've always been and remain a very close family. A little known fact is we have three generations of osteopathic physicians in our family. My dad, William Frank Baker, graduated from the Des Moines College of Osteopathic Medicine in 1950. He then went directly across the street to do his internship for $50 a month at the Still Hospital. I was born at that hospital in January of that year. So you could say I was born into the profession and I never left. Carrie is the third generation Baker to hold the title DO. I have had the privilege of working closely with Boyd R. Boozer through these last 12 months, watching him as he worked tirelessly, defining our culture, addressing difficult issues, improving our association, and strengthening the family. I want to thank you publicly, Boyd, for your leadership, your mentorship, and your friendship. It has been an honor to serve with you. The AOA has a very robust strategic plan, approved by this House of Delegates last summer. I want to assure you that work on that plan will be ongoing. But that is not what I want to discuss today. Today, I want to talk about us. That's right, us. Everyone in this room, our profession, and our association. My focus this year revolves around three areas: improving the communication and relationship with our affiliates, engaging the youth of our profession, and promoting unity within our osteopathic family. I'd like to have a candid conversation about where the osteopathic profession is currently and our many opportunities for the future. We need to remember that we are all part of the same family, the osteopathic family. Think about it. Each and every one of you in this house is here for a few common reasons. You all have a love for our osteopathic profession. You all want to give back, and you all want to ensure that the future of osteopathic medicine is bright. As part of the same professional family, we have a shared culture, that of osteopathic medicine, our distinctive philosophy and practice of medicine. Throughout its history, our profession has addressed many challenges and not only survived, but prospered. And why should now be any different? Are we not just as committed as our forefathers? We need to embrace the opportunities and changes before us and ensure our future prosperity. Over the past year, many of you have heard me talk about the growth in our profession. With the addition of the graduating class of 2017, we have officially surpassed 130,000 active DOs and osteopathic medical students. Our family is getting larger, and that means more chairs at the table. Our profession is in a position that most organizations would give their right arm to have. We are rapidly growing, one of the fastest growing segments of healthcare professionals. We're becoming significantly younger. 53% of all DOs are under the age of 45. And we are becoming more diverse. 46% of DOs under 45 are female. And since 2011, we have had a 63% increase in women DOs under the age of 35. Our challenge is to take advantage of this rapid growth, to harness this energy for a common cause, moving our profession forward and remodeling the AOA for future generations of DOs. This future includes the opportunity for MDs to join us at the table, to become AOA certified, to become members, and to practice osteopathically. But let's be perfectly clear. They are joining us. We are not changing to become them. Our mission continues to be to advance the distinctive philosophy and practice of osteopathic medicine. Over the past several years, the AOA has undergone some many important, significant changes. Changes that were necessary. Even our founder, A.T. Still, understood the need for change when he said, "Let us not be governed today by what we did yesterday, nor tomorrow by what we did today. For day by day, we must show progress." But change can be uncomfortable, and sometimes change is disruptive. Here at the AOA, change has put pressure on several segments of our family. This brings us to my first area of focus this year, improving the communication and relationship with our affiliates. As the AOA grows and changes to meet the challenges of today and tomorrow, it is important for us to circle back and make sure that all of the family, including our affiliates, are healthy, and that everyone has a shared strategic vision of our future. Today, we have an opportunity to strengthen the alignment with our affiliates, both state and specialty societies. We must work with them to increase their level of relevance for a new generation of DOs. Maximizing the strength of both our affiliates and the AOA advances our osteopathic profession. This process must be based on clear, direct, and honest communication around issues that are mutually beneficial to all. We have an affiliate alignment task force composed predominantly of executive directors of our state and specialty societies, addressing areas of common concern. I look forward to the recommendations of this task force. My commitment to both AOSED and SOCE is that we, you and I, will sit down and have a face-to-face meeting discussing these recommendations. I assure you, our affiliates are an important and integral part of all that we do as the AOA and the osteopathic profession. This brings us to my second area of focus this year, engaging the youth of our profession. Today, the AOA has a multitude of opportunities in front of it, many of them arising out of a new generation of DOs and their changing needs and wants. They have dedicated themselves to the osteopathic profession. Now we must acknowledge them, respond to their needs, and build an even stronger sense of belonging to the family. As our residency and fellowship programs transition to the single accreditation system, it is important for them to apply for and obtain osteopathic recognition. Remember, osteopathic GME is not going away. It will merely be known as a program with osteopathic recognition. Repeatedly, the overwhelming majority of our osteopathic medical students have told us they want to train in osteopathically recognized programs. We must give them that opportunity and increase our capacity. We must talk to educators and students about the value of osteopathic board certification, its assessment of our osteopathic competencies in a physician-friendly format that is convenient and cost-effective. We have an opportunity to engage the youngest members of our profession, ensuring that the resources we provide them are cutting edge, but at the same time, grounded in osteopathic philosophy, and encouraging them to be active, contributing members of the family. We must welcome their voices to join in the discussion. Our younger members bring with them a heightened level of energy and inquisitiveness into our profession. It is this type of energy and passion and willingness to think in new and innovative ways that we as an association need. This energy and passion for our profession are vital for our boards, our governing bodies, and our affiliates. Give them a seat at the table and encourage them to get involved. Help them develop their leadership skills because they are our future. Finally, this brings us to my third area of focus this year, promoting unity within our osteopathic family. Very simply, our future is dependent upon our unity. We must all work together to increase the level of trust and respect that we have for each other's contributions to the profession. It's okay to disagree, but let's be constructive and work together. Because at the end of the day, we are a family. Many of you may know that for 5 years, I had the pleasure of serving as Speaker of this House. I have great faith in this House of Delegates and its policy-making authority for the AOA. It is important for us all to remember we are a physician-directed and driven association. That the policies adopted by this body direct the actions of the Board of Trustees and the administration. These policies are established by this House of Delegates with representation of DOs from across this great country. Delegates, thank you for your commitment and all that you do for the AOA. So, how do we move our profession forward? Former University of Texas football coach Darrell Royal used to say it this way: you dance with who brung you. Translating that out of Texan for you, it means that you rely on those who got you where you are. Yes, us, you and me, everyone in this room, from our students to our most seasoned leaders, the family. This profession has given everyone in this room a great opportunity. You were given the opportunity to become an osteopathic physician. You were given the opportunity to serve mankind by improving health. And you were given the opportunity to provide a fulfilling and comfortable lifestyle for yourselves and your family. But with this opportunity, you also have an obligation. You have an obligation to give back to our current students, the osteopathic profession, and the AOA. We all owe this profession more than we can ever repay. Former AOA President Norm Vinn said it this way during his inaugural speech: we must harness the strength of our culture to enhance our strategic plan and preserve our unity. My call to action today for this distinguished body is that each and every one of you join me in improving the communication and relationship with our affiliates, engaging the youth of our profession, and promoting unity within our osteopathic family. Last year, President Boozer challenged us to let your inner DO out. Allow those characteristics that define DOs to shine brightly in everything that we do, propelling our profession forward. In other words, our future is in our hands, and it shines brightly. In fact, over the past year, at every comm I visited, I told the students that their future is so bright, you gotta wear shades.
Better. Ladies and gentlemen, our future is bright. In closing, I would like to quote Andrew Taylor Still, who said, "Let your light so shine that the world will know you are an osteopathic physician. Pure and simple. And that no greater title can follow a human name. We are a family, the osteopathic family. Thank you, osteopathic family, and God bless you all." Thank you.